Like, what is the definition of taqleed? When the taqleed is acceptable and when the taqleed is not acceptable? Because, as I asked you, there is a group, when we call on them, we tell them, okay, no, you are following a certain imam. This is a blind taqleed. You should go behind, check on him, check the hadith, whether he said it or no. Then they call that, okay, you are also following the same taqleed. If you are following Bukhari, Imam Bukhari, this is also a taqleed. So what is acceptable in this?
Generally speaking, taqleed means I imitate somebody without knowing his proofs. Like how the child prays like his parents. What he's doing taqleed. Why you are raising your hand, why you are making sujood, the child doesn't know, but he is imitating his father, his mother. This is taqleed. What my imam is saying, what he's doing, I am doing blindly. Why he's doing this, I don't know. Generally, this is taqleed. This is different than littiba'. Littiba', no, I know his dalil, I know his way. No, he's doing this because there's hadith, there's an ayah. Okay? And we should think about this big issue in the Muslim Ummah. Okay? To make the differences less. Okay? Go back to the time of Sahaba and Tabi'een, or that specifically the time of Tabi'een. Okay? How they were practicing Islam. Yani, for example, if the Tabi'i saw Uthman ibn Affan, then he asked him a question, a fiqh issue, the fiqh issue. And then later, if he has another fiqh issue, did he say, khalas, I have to ask Uthman because the first time I asked Uthman, so I have to stick to the way of Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu anhu? No. Khalas, he trusts Uthman radiallahu ta'ala. He trusts Umar ibn Khattab. He trusts Abdullah ibn Umar. What I mean, he trusts? He knows this person, or the people know, the Tabi'in know, that they are our scholars. They are giving fatwa out of the Quran and Sunnah. So the Muslims should practice the same way. I should ask the scholar that I believe he is following the Quran and Sunnah. Nobody's, I'm not finding the Quran that if you ask one sheikh, khalas, you have to stick to this sheikh. And this is taqleed. If you, for example, if you study the Hanafi madhab, khalas, you have to stick to the Hanafi madhab for your life. Or if you want to change, khalas, you change to another madhab and you stick to the other madhab. Who said this? What is the proof from the Quran and Sunnah? Allah says in the Quran clearly, فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ إِن كُنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Allah says in the Quran, ask the people of dhikr, the people of knowledge. It means the scholar, if you don't know. He did not say stick to one sheikh. Okay? So, imitation, taqleed means to imitate somebody without knowing the dalil. Okay? When it is allowed, when I cannot search for the proof. Yani, for example, I am in the Hajj. I'm in the Hajj with Hamla, with the group of people, and there is Sheikh for this Hamla. Okay? So I asked the Sheikh, now what we'll do? Say, we go to Muzdalifa. Khas, we go with him. Then after Muzdalifa, like we go to Mina, we go to Mecca. So we are imitating him. There is no time to ask him about every single issue, what is the proof. So khas, we are making taqleed.
This is acceptable.
This is acceptable if you cannot read and ask and search. If you cannot. Yani, you know the situation in Hajj. Yani, there are some hamla come far from Asia, from Africa. They don't know the language. Even some of them don't know how to read. They are illiterates. So can we tell them, yalla, go and search Bukhari, Muslim, Sahih, Al-Albani? They cannot. So how they can do Hajj? Khalas, follow your sheikh. So in this case, this taqleed is acceptable. Even the biggest scholars, like Sheikh Al-Uthaymeen, he mentioned, in some issue I will make taqleed of Sheikh Islam Taymiyyah. Why? Because he doesn't have the proof. He cannot make ijtihad in this issue. So So I say, I will imitate Sheikh Islam Taymiyyah. Because I did not find the correct answer in this issue.
Okay. So meaning Sheikh, for example, if somebody, Sheikh is telling me a hadith, then I can still tell him, okay, show me a proof, or I can still go and check on him on that. Meaning the hadith, the platform itself is researchable. Like I can do my own study. Like for example, Sheikh Albani, he did some takhrij on Sahih al-Bukhari. He found some hadith and he did his own research. And he said that, okay, I found these hadith as not, I think he classified them as Hasan. And then he mentioned something. So this is acceptable. Like it is not called that, no, he is deviated. The Sheikh Albani is deviated in this way because he found his own way and Sheikh, we have to follow the Sheikh al-Bukhari. So what is your saying on
this?
Yes,
of course. Yani, at the beginning, somebody quote for you a hadith, authentic hadith, okay, or a hadith. From where this hadith said, this hadith, Sahih Muslim, Sahih Bukhari. And you don't have any idea about this issue. Okay, khas. Zaka al khair, I have to respect the hadith and I have to follow. Why? Because this is my knowledge now. But this will not stop me from researching.
Okay.
So, okay, now, yeah, for example, if somebody told you, okay, you have to move the sunnah to move your finger because there is hadith in Sahih Muslim to move your finger, for example. Khas, inshallah, Zaka al khair, I'll move my finger. Okay, but after the salah, okay, I'll go and search. Okay, if I'm feeling doubt or if I like to seek more knowledge about this issue, go and search. Maybe you'll find this hadith is not authentic. Or maybe you find this hadith is authentic and there is another hadith and we can do this way in salah and there is another way. So go and search.
Okay, so this is acceptable.
Yes, of course.
Okay, so based on this, Sheikh, like for example, ijtihad, the matter of ijtihad, because now this is all, alhamdulillah, getting the chain same. Ijtihad. I can make my own ijtihad. For example, if I am in a situation where I don't know, okay, what to do. I don't have a proof right now. I cannot search. I don't have the means ready with me. So can I make my own ijtihad?
What is the other option? Now you have an option. I do my own ijtihad. What is the other option?
Like for example,
You are in a situation. You don't know where is the qibla. It is night. Or it is a cloudy day, you cannot see the sun. Mm-hmm. And you don't know where is the qibla.
You will make your own ijtihad. What is
that?
What is
the
other
option?
There is no other option.
Khalas.
So
this is what Allah wants from you.
Mm.
You worship Him according to your ability. فَاتَّقُوا مَا اسْتَطَعْتُ. I do my ijtihad, I came from this side, the sun may be this side, this is the qibla side.
You just have to put a little bit of your thought and
Yes. And sometimes maybe you have some references, like the situation when Ammar bin Yasir radiallahu ta'ala and another Sahaba, I think Umar al-Khattab, okay? He had janaba, so he had to take a shower, but they don't have water. So what he did, I think Ammar bin Yasir, he went down and he did like the animal on the ground. Yeah, like taking shower from the dust on the ground. From where this started, he said, because if I want wudu and I don't have water, so I do tayammum for the hands and face. But now I want ikhtisal and ikhtisal for the whole body, so I have to do the same thing. So he did his own ijtihad. Yes, it is wrong, but he has a reference.
Okay.
The Prophet later told him, no, it is enough to touch the ground one time and you do tayammum for your hands and your face.
Okay. So Sheikh, now the fourth category which comes into this is like, for example, if there is an ijma' of the ummah, and that is also like we have to follow.
Yes.
It's like the consensus. You have
ijma',
to...
Ijma', yes, khalas. Ijma'. And some people think ijma' is something not from the Quran and Sunnah. It is only from the scholars. No, some of the issues from the Quran, or mainly the issues from the Quran and Sunnah. Yeah, for example, there is ijma' that the five prayers are compulsory. Ijma'. Okay, is it from the scholars? No, this is from the Quran and Sunnah. Allah says, وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةِ. The Prophet ﷺ mentioned the hadith, خَمْسُ صَلَوَاتِ, five prayers in the day and night. Okay? So, ijma', some people think ijma' from scholars. No, ijma' from the Quran and Sunnah mainly.